there is a certain kind of identification.
That's exactly, I was going to say recognition, but identification.
Yeah, there was one woman in San Francisco who said, how do you manage to write about an Indian American woman? Because that's what you have been doing, you know? Yeah. I said, no, I haven't. I've written about a Scandinavian middle-aged man. And she said, no, it's my...
Indian American, she said that.
Yeah, she said that.
You were in my soul. You were in my head. You were in my heart.
Yeah, something like that. And I think that has to do with, you know, my experience with this project is I set out to try to find out who am I.
Who you are.
Yes, and that was the project. How did I become the man I am, you know? How did it happen? What is identity? What is it to be someone? And I thought I'd just be as private and intimate as I could and be as true as I could to myself. And I thought this was
as
so
intimate, meaning revealing as much as you possibly could.
Yes, I'm writing things in there that I haven't said to a single living person, you know. It's been my secrets, but it's in the book. So I thought this was too private and too personal. And I thought there would be no recognition and no identification possible in this book. But it doesn't work like that. It's like, I think we are much, much more alike than we think we are.
And meaning that we have the same hopes, the same fears, the same...
Yeah, and I think in this book I'm writing about how it is to be 17, you know. And I think the feeling of being 17 is the same everywhere, you know. And it's those kind of feelings I'm trying to capture in the book. The presence of you know, the different ages. I'm writing about when I'm 10 and 17.
And it says something about the reader. It says something about you, but it also says something about the reader.
Yeah.